working, you know, with some of the biggest Hollywood movie and television stars can be exciting, but there's a part of it that becomes kind of your, it's just your day, you know? You don't realize that it's exciting because it's your life, basically, you know? And so I've met like a lot of people that I was, you know, that I admired. You know, when I lived in New York, at one point I worked with Warren Beatty, and, you know, I grew up with him on the big screen, and, you know, in life he was, you know, just a really nice person. He didn't have a lot of affectations of a movie star. He was just really, he's charming, but he was really smart and really nice. And so LA's kind of like that. Everybody drives their own car. It doesn't matter how famous you are or how much money you have, you know, nobody's being chauffeured around. You know, everybody drives their own car. And, movie stars are just like everybody else at a certain extent. I mean, they have their good days and their bad days. Actors in general, I think, because like I met Bruce Willis, for instance, when I first moved to New York. He was a bartender. It's before he really hit it big on Moonlighting, and he used to sneak me free bourbon occasionally from Cafe Central. And you know, they remember their roots. They remember the struggle. They remembered how many times, you know, they called him an instant star, but he auditioned a lot for a long time, you know. And you know, they, in my experience, especially some of the bigger stars, they all remember, you know, what it felt like to be a waiter, what it felt like to audition for a bunch of things, and they're some of the nicest people, you know. There's big egos everywhere in every kind of job, and it's high stakes with a lot of money, but you know, usually actors want to be, they want to present the best side of themselves. They want to, their characters to be redeemable in some way. Even if they play like a bad guy, they want to know that it comes from something organic, if that makes sense. And with comedy, you know, people, you know, want to know that the comedy is relatable. And I had a reputation for working on things that were kind of organic, where it wasn't like slapstick humor. You know, on Dream On, we tackled amazing subject matter. Jeff Greenstein and Jeff Strauss were partners then. They went on to create a bunch of great shows and to work on different shows separately, and I'm still real close with them. And they were just the most amazing mentors, because we would really, they're amazing writers that were great comedy writers, great joke writers, but as storytellers, the stories always had to be very organic and interesting plot twists. So I learned from some of the best people in television, and it really made me acutely aware of how important the plot was. So I always tried to work on things of that caliber, if that makes any sense. So Jeff Greenstein went on and did Desperate Housewives and a bunch of different shows, and when we worked on Dream On, it was a cable show for HBO, but we did amazing work on that show because we just had a really great group of writers, and Brian Benben is a terrific actor. I mean, he can like come in and walk right on a chalkboard and make you laugh. I don't know what it is about him, but there was something very human about it. I mean, Jeremy Piven is another example. I got to work with him a couple of times, and on Ellen, and then on another sitcom that I co-created, and there's something about him that is so, he can make you laugh and cry almost in the same minute, and it's so very real. You know, people know him from Entourage, and they think he's a little bit like Ari Emanuel, but in real life, I mean, he can just, you know, read the phone book, and you're interested in it, and that's, there's just something about a certain movie star that has that, like you can't take your eyes off them. And to be able to work with people that could elevate whatever lines you gave them is such a treat, you know?